what's new in Modern Warfare 3? There's quite a few things. We've added a lot to the single player, including, you know, new bigger maps, which are now pretty tall. So we've gone to urban environments, which makes the gameplay different. We've gone all the way to Europe and the Himalayas, Africa. So it's a bigger conflict with more types of fighting. So we work with the SAS in Britain, GIGN in France, and German mechanized units. So we kind of follow their type of gameplay. Spec Ops, we've added a lot. So Spec Ops, you know, was just this mission mode, which people loved in Modern Warfare 2. This game, we've added survival mode. And survival mode uses all the multiplayer maps, brings it into survival mode, which is a true co-op mode. You can play, with your buddy on the couch, you can play online, you can even play by yourself if you want. The idea here is that you can play these infinite waves of enemies, and you get to learn the enemies, you get to learn your weapons, but you also get to use the maps. And you're playing in a fun environment. Once you get to know them really well, and you get to know the upgrading system and everything, you can bring it over and start playing multiplayer. And that's where a lot of people have a lot of fun. We've also changed the way we use kill streaks and everything in multiplayer. If you went out there and you were more of a team player, and you went out and tried to help your team, but you were getting killed all the time and not getting rewarded for that, well, we've changed that. We still kept it for the hardcore as well, but we've also allowed people to get, upgraded. We have the attachments, and we also have camos and everything else like that for the weapons, but we've also brought in proficiencies. Proficiencies allow you to add attributes to your particular weapon. Let's say you want to add, I don't want to flinch as much, I don't want to sway, I don't want the, kickback. You can do that with your weapon. You could also have, say, hold your breath when you're using the ADS mode for the assault rifle. And what that does is the more that you use your weapon, the more advanced it becomes, just like you are upgrading yourself, that will allow you to upgrade your weapon. And we've also added a few game modes. There's one in particular that we really like is Kill Confirmed. This is the first time I've seen in a while that the game teams have like rushed towards a new game mode. And Kill Confirmed is a lot of fun. The Task Force 141 is either dead or on the run, and play the game and you'll find out more. But we've added some new characters, the Delta Force characters, the SAS characters. There's a really good story here, and we've spent so much time on it to make sure that it made sense, that that it tugged on your heartstrings, but it also worked as a camaraderie movie. And this game really takes its script seriously. I think there's a few secrets. I think first and foremost is the fun gameplay, right? It's just fun to pick up. I think secondly, it's also easy to get into, right? So I can pick up the controller, I understand it pretty well, and I get in, and the game is fast. And speaking of fast, right? It's fast to get in. So if you die, boom, you'll get back right in the game again. Same thing with multiplayer. I might get in, there's immediately contact. I'm working with my other players, or I'm meeting the enemy. And if I die in there, I'm boom, boom, back into the game again. So there's not this waiting around all the time. But as far as the characters go, Price and Soap and Ghost and those guys are some of the most beloved characters in video game history. And people really do associate with them. People write to me every day about Ghost. When are you bringing Ghost back? Is Price alive? Is Soap alive? So I think that people have affection for them and want to know how they're doing. And people are already starting to get into Sandman and Frost, who aren't even out yet. So we hope they do, because we spent a lot of time on them.
It doesn't take the most powerful nations on Earth to create the next global conflict.
I got to be perfectly honest with you, is when I wake up every day, I don't think about them. I think about working on the biggest game in history and how I must make that better. I think that Modern Warfare 2 is my competitor. I need to make a game that's better than Modern Warfare 2. I need the one that feels good, that feels like it's the next one in line, that does it justice, that does it honor. And so that's what I look at all the time. Am I living up to that? That benchmark of greatness, which it really is. So the competitors, I let marketing think about that. Well, you know, imitation is the greatest form of flattery. So, I'm flattered. I don't know what to say. I'm all about the game that we're making and really proud of it. And that's what I think about, is how do we make Modern Warfare 3 better, not who's behind me. You know, I'm looking forward. So maybe they don't know enough about video games. I don't know. Growing up, my mom wouldn't let me watch violent TV because she thought, well, that's going to lead to this. So, and when the movies first came out in the 20s and 30s, people said, oh, they're going to cause people to do this or that. You know, if you're a violent, bad person, you're going to do something, whether you read a book, you watch a video game. I think it's a little naive to always blame video games, or maybe it's just not really understanding what they are. Most of the people that will accuse us, the video game industry, have probably never played a video game. They don't realize that millions and millions of people get entertainment and fun and relaxation and socialization. All that come out of video games, and I think that they brought a lot more good than harm.
Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3, product not yet rated.